day and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time tuning in, and thank you for joining me on this tech journey. I'm Stefan, and this is the OnePlus 6T in 2021 review on 868 Tech TV. I've been using the OnePlus 6T for about a week, and I must say, I'm impressed. At first glance, this phone really isn't much to look at with its minimalistic design. A dual camera on the back, some OnePlus branding, and a small notch for the selfie camera and face unlock on the front. It has Gorilla Glass 6 on the front and glass in the back, which was pretty good for a mid-range phone in 2018, though this did not translate to the OnePlus 6T being equipped with wireless charging. What a waste of glass, right? The phone feels good in the hand, not heavy at all, and slim enough so that one-handed usage is quite comfortable. Unlike these behemoths of a device we're seeing these days, for example, the lower tier Pixel 6, while price friendly, is still a beast of a phone in more ways than one. It's quite tall and wide as well, not meant for one-hand use. On the right side of the phone, there is the power button, and just above that is an alert slider. Now, this is something similar to what we've seen on iPhones for quite some time. Unlike the iPhone, this has three modes: loud, vibrate, and silent. So rather than having to go into your phone to change those things around, it's literally right at your fingertips. On the left side, we have your volume rocker, and just above that is your SIM tree. There's no expandable storage option. There's a mic on top with a dual speaker grill on the bottom, and I'll tell you more about those later. And a Type-C USB port as well. The screen is a 6.4 optic AMOLED, whatever that means, and it's at 1080p resolution. Don't take that to mean it's not a good screen, because it is. As a result of the AMOLED panel, it does get quite bright colors, if not a little too bright, but you can fix the color accuracy in the settings if you're into that sort of thing. Next to my Pixel 3 XL, this was a breath of fresh air. And it does get quite bright in the sun, so legibility should not be a problem. Now, this coming from someone who lives in one of the hottest parts of the world, where the sun seems to be hotter and brighter here than anywhere else. This is my first foray into OxygenOS, and I was not disappointed. The operating system is buttery smooth, and it's pretty close to stock Android, but with some innovative additions that you don't find on any other phone. You have all your regular Android 11 features, including system-wide dark mode, screen recording, and some updated privacy options, though it's not nearly as good as on Android 12. All your connections are available: Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Android Auto, NFC, and even casting is there. There are some unique display modes, such as visual comfort, which is basically a blue light filter, and reading mode, which makes it easier to read your articles, books, etc., regardless of the environment. There is an always-on display, albeit a simple one, quite similar to what we see on Pixel devices. It gives you the basic information: your date, time, alarm, and incoming notifications. One of the best features of OnePlus's OxygenOS is its customizability. Did I say that right? Customizability. And when I say customizability, I don't just mean your wallpapers or widgets, but even icon packs, system icons, and even accent color, which is now available on all Android devices running Android 12. All of this is available on Android 11, right on OxygenOS, and without the need to download any third-party applications such as Nova or Apex Launcher. So you can fully customize your phone to your heart's desire. Whether you want rounded icons or you want to download an all-new icon pack, that's up to you. On to the buttons and gestures, and this is where OnePlus kicked it up a notch. The previously mentioned alert slider can be customized within the settings. You can also choose to have a navigation bar and use your gestures, or if you like it old school, you can choose to have your regular on-screen buttons for back, home, and recent apps. The meat though is in the quick gestures, which allows you to draw various shapes and designs on the phone screen to do a multitude of tasks, from taking screenshots to opening apps. The buttons themselves are quite clicky and responsive. I like that. When it comes to sound, the OnePlus 6T is just okay. Now, I have some experience in this area, working in the music and radio industry for over 13 years and still going. There is barely any bass, and though the audio sounds clean, it doesn't get nearly loud enough. even in quiet situations. Phone calls and other voice activity should be fine though. Now, what I was impressed with straight off the bat was the amazing haptics. If this phone isn't your cup of tea for most things and you're into haptics, then get this device. It is hands down one of the best haptic feedback experiences I've ever had on a mobile phone. Even for a 3-year-old phone, battery life from this is surprisingly good. I don't know what OnePlus has done to achieve such good battery life years later, but this is much better than my Pixel 3 XL and can definitely get you through a full day of what I would call regular usage. Charging is fast, not quick at 20 watts, but it is what it is and there is no wireless charging available. OnePlus does security well. There are all the options you need on this device. You can unlock it by inputting your pattern or your PIN. Face unlock works fine. And finally, the under-display fingerprint reader. I know back in 2018 this wasn't the most advanced fingerprint reader, but this one definitely is hit or miss, and I'm sure it could have gotten at least slightly better even with some updates, but sadly it didn't, so you're stuck with what you get. The OnePlus 60 is using a Snapdragon 845 chipset with the Adreno 630 and 6GB of RAM, and not surprisingly, it does perform admirably under stress and only got slightly hot in my gaming test, which I edited so you won't see my absolutely horrible Call of Duty Mobile gameplay. Day-to-day tasks should be a breeze, so no need to worry about your phone slowing down. Finally, it's on to the cameras. The OnePlus 60 is equipped with two sensors in the back, a 16MP and a 20MP, both at f1.7 aperture, and only the 16MP has optical image stabilization. They both natively shoot at 16MP. Frankly, I don't really understand what OnePlus tried to do with these cameras, and the quality is just okay. And that's comparing it to my Pixel 3 XL, which came out the same year and around the same time. If you're gonna have two cameras, at least one should have a main focus, whether it's an ultra-wide or telephoto. But effectively putting the same two cameras on the phone was a waste of space. But hey, they do shoot in 4K, up to 60 frames per second. Now, on the front, there's a 16MP that does 1080p at 30 frames per second, and photos came out a bit soft and lacking in detail, so not ideal for those selfies. Overall, not the best camera quality.
So, that just about wraps it up for the OnePlus 60 in 2021. A decent phone with some flagship specs that I would say is a good deal, considering the price that it's currently going for. Now, if you're looking for something with similar specs but a much better camera, I would highly recommend the Pixel 3 XL, which I've recently reviewed. I'll leave the link in the description. That's it for today. Thank you for joining me, and feel free to leave a comment and let me know your thoughts on the review. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and ding that notification bell so you never miss another video. Also, let me know what other phones or gadgets you would like to see me review, and connect with me by my social media links. Until the next one, I'm Stefan for 868 Tech TV, and I'll catch you later.